Hey everybody, what's going on? Josh here with Scrapyard Films, and today I got another tutorial for you, but this one's gonna be for Streamlabs OBS. I'm gonna show you how to set it up and get the best possible streaming settings for a bad PC. If you wanna learn how to do this, stick around for the tutorial. If not, I got plenty of other tutorials on my channel. Feel free to check out if you want. Okay, so let's get started. So Streamlabs OBS is basically a custom program built on OBS. So it shares a lot of the same features, but it's built more for professional streamers, and it has a lot of built-in functionality, looks, and some real general awesome things that are just really beneficial for streamers specifically. So to get the best streaming settings, if you go up to the top right, you're going to see a little gear icon. Click on that, it brings up your settings window. From here, the first thing you want to do is go to video, and then we are going to choose base canvas resolution, and then output scaled resolution. This is for non-affiliates and affiliates if you have a bad PC. You'd still want to downscale this to 720p. Now, if you have a really bad PC, you may want to consider gaming in 720p. So you could change your base canvas to 720 and then keep your output scaled at 720. And then we choose the downscale filter. Put it bilinear or bicubic. It shouldn't make a difference if you aren't scaling, if these numbers are the same. But if you are scaling, do bilinear or bicubic. See which one works better for you. Usually bilinear is for the worst computer. Common FPS type. We don't need to mess with this. We could just choose common. And then the FPS value. You don't want to go above 30. Once you're done with that, go to output. Go to output mode and advanced. Audio track, we're going to choose one of these options, whichever one you're primarily recording with. So if you look down here to the right, you'll see all of your audio that you have recording. Like here's my voice right here. And if you click the gear to the top right of that whole window, it'll tell you what track all these are recording on. So right here, 1 through 6. So you can selectively choose which audio track you want these to record on. But for the most part, everything's just going to be one. Since it's on one, you don't have to change any of this unless you're adding a lot of different audio inputs. So back to settings, click that, go back to our output, audio track, 1 through 6, it doesn't matter because all these are on there, so we're just going to choose one. Encoder. Now what the encoder does is it takes your video and then translates it and then sends it off to your streaming destination, which is usually Twitch or YouTube Gaming or something like that. An encoder X264 means that your processor is going to be encoding your video and translating it, and anything else over here means it's your graphics card. This word will change for different graphics cards and onboard graphics. So let's just say you are gaming on a terrible PC, but you have an okay graphics card. You can choose NVENC and it'll use your graphics card to encode this whole stream and send it to Twitch or wherever. But if you don't have that good of a graphics card and you still have a kind of bad processor, your safest bet is using Software X264. Make sure this box is checked, and then rescale output. You only need to check this one if you are rescaling your base canvas resolution to an output scaled resolution that's different. So if you're gaming in 1080p and then you downscale it to 720p, then you want to check rescale output. So we are gaming in 720p and not scaling it, so we don't need that. Rate control, you have 4 options here. CBR means control bitrate. You tell it a bitrate and it does its best to keep it right at that bitrate the entire time. Usually for non-affiliates, you don't want to go above 2500 to 3000. But if you have a bad PC, you're going to probably want to put this number at around 2000 to 2500. CBR is a great one to use. Another good one to use is ABR, which is average bitrate. Basically, you tell it a bitrate and it has a little bit of leeway depending on what goes on in that screen to fluctuate the bitrate to make sure there's very little pixelation and very little buffering. VBR is variable bitrate. It's pretty much the same thing as ABR. It has a little bit of fluctuation room for the bitrate depending on what goes on in the screen, but you're allowed to tell it a CRF number, which is basically a quality number from 0 to 51. 0 being the best and biggest file size, 51 being the worst and smallest file size. Usually a good number for this, if you have a bad PC, is probably 25 to 30, but you probably shouldn't even use this one if you have a bad PC, because CRF means it's working extra hard to match the quality of the previous frame every frame. That's what that's doing. So we really don't want to use VBR if you have a bad PC. And CRF is exactly what I just explained, control rate factor. It tries to match the quality of every frame previous to it. So if you have this to a lower number, it's going to be higher quality, but higher file size, meaning you're going to be transmitting a giant file to Twitch and all your viewers watching you are going to suffer while they try to watch this because it's such a huge file they have to download, especially if you're not affiliated. Then your viewers don't have transcoding on your stream, making it even harder for them to watch your stuff fluently. So your best bet is probably doing ABR at 2500 to maybe even 2000. Don't need custom buffer size, keyframe intervals, keep that there, CPU usage. Here's the thing about this, it's a little bit confusing sometimes, but basically, the higher you are up here in your list, the less computer processing power it's going to take to encode. Now this also will mean your stream may suffer a little bit in quality, but it's not too bad, especially if you have a bad PC, you want this way up here, probably super fast area. But if you go down here to the bottom left and look at your CPU usage, then you'll be seeing if that's hitting a high number. If that's above 80 or 90, then you're still pushing your limits. You may need to go to ultra fast. But if you're on super fast and this is hitting like 50 or 40, then you can drop it down to very fast or faster because that'll improve the quality of your stream and your computer can handle it. So we'll say super fast. Profile, high baseline or none. Usually just skip baseline. Don't even worry about that one. Main profile means it's better for transcoding and people watching on their phones. So if somebody's streaming on their Android, then that's something you can choose as main profile. That'll allow them to watch that stream a lot better. But high is more compatible with everything else. Computers, TVs, and just about the most used streaming platform out there is your computer. So high is the most compatible with that. That's the one I go for as a safe bet. Tune. Don't worry about that. Leave it at none. That's all proprietary. And then this option, leave it blank. And then that is the best streaming settings you can have for a bad PC on Streamlabs OBS. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to comment below. That's going to wrap it up for this tutorial. Hey everybody, thanks for watching that tutorial. If that helped you out, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, because that'll help me out, and that'll let me know what you guys want to see next. Also, if you want, you can check out my Patreon. The more patrons I have, the more frequent I can do my giveaways, and the better the prizes will be. I also sell shirts and stuff on Amazon and TeePublic, so all the links will be in the description below. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.